Hello everyone. Well, I decided to go ahead and start Project Life. It's been around for a few years now, and different companies have kind of come up with similar concepts but didn't call it the same. Project 365, We Are Memory Keepers has had their line of page protectors out for a few years now. So anyway, I finally decided to jump on the bandwagon. And hopefully I can tell this story without getting overly emotional. This book is entitled Good Times, and there's a very good reason for that. It has had those letters inside of this pocket page for the past 3-4 years now. I picked that title because the year I had my stroke, 2008, I was pretty much rendered completely disabled. I was not able to function at all that year. And my oldest daughter would keep saying, "I miss the good times," and that just broke my heart. So for a long time, I've had those letters in that pocket page to try to build this book to explain to them that there's still good times to be had. I'm still here. This disease I have isn't going to kill me. I had the stroke in 2008 and diagnosed with multiple sclerosis in 2009. So it's been a hard battle, it's been an uphill battle, and it's been very difficult, and I think that's why I have not scrapbooked the day in the life. I have continued to scrapbook our trips. We've gone to Mexico, Los Cabos, I went on a cruise. I mean, there's other things we have done, and I did make sure to scrapbook those, but I haven't really gotten to do a lot with the day in the life since 2008. So that's why I've decided to go ahead and move forward with Project Life. And a lot of it comes from finally this year. I did the Marion Smith Challenge in January of the 31 days. And I have videos of this posted if you want to see it from the past. And I really enjoyed doing this project. But this project is very time consuming and very detail oriented. It's a lot of work. Now that I'm back to working almost full-time and the kids are in school and they're in dance, they're in violin, they're in all these events, I really need something simple. So I decided to go forward with Project Life, and this is how it had originally started. These are my originals from back when just everyday life type of stuff. This was in 2007. These were just bits and pieces of layouts of everyday life that I had started to do at that time. This is the year that the stroke hit, which was 2008, and I really didn't get much done. So I really like this layout here. It's really cute, and I have a lot of pictures from that day. So I'm going to make the other layout. So this particular binder of Project Life is going to just finish wrapping up these few years that I've missed of hit and miss type of things. This was my very first, if you want to call it, trip out of the house. This was a very big event for me, and it was through the loving kindness of my mother-in-law. This was in August of 2008. I was just being able to start walking again by this point. This was about 6 months after the stroke, I guess. And so this was a big event that was really special to the girls, and it's all a huge thank you to my mother-in-law that I was even able to do that with them. So it was the Butterfly Gardens, and that was just a really big event in time for us. That was August 13th, 2008. And again, at this point, I did not have that much energy, so I was not scrapbooking a lot. We did go to Mexico this month as well, and I did do that scrapbook, and that was the only scrapbook I was able to finish in 2008. This also was a party that we went ahead and had for the kids here locally. It was something I could do because this place is practically in our backyard, so we just scheduled for a whole bunch of their friends to come to this place called Bounce Town, and they all had a good time. This was just a pool party at a friend's house that summer. And then I'm getting a little stronger here. This is January of 2009. It was our first time back to my in-laws' farm, and we invited a whole bunch of their friends. We let off fireworks, and they had a blast. And then this was a bowling party, and this is in 2009. And here's our Pooch. She's been my friendly little furry friend to have ever since I had the stroke. She's pretty much been with us since September of 2008, and she's just kind of been my homebody while I was stuck at home for a while. This was my first big, what I call, walking trip. Being in New York City, you can just imagine how much walking there was. And my parents live in Connecticut, so this was a very big deal for the girls. This was their first time to New York City, and I have not finished this. So this is where I will be starting because they enjoyed this trip so much. My parents were kind enough to be willing to join us. We went ahead and bought tickets to do the Red Bus Tour on, I guess it's called Blue Line, or Gray Line. It's called Gray Line. Gray Line Tours in New York City. And that enabled me to not have to run up and down stairs because I could not do stairs still at that time. And I was able to just get on a bus and we could tour the city. We could get on and off at different locations. Of course, everything is handicapped accessible. And it was just a really great trip. So my parents helped out a lot on this trip. So we did, you know, all the typical FAO Schwartz, World Trade Center, Battery Park. I still need to include my daughter's favorite was Statue of Liberty. So that's what these pages are supposed to be. And this is what I really wanted to show. So this is the Empire State Building layout. And you'll notice this right here is very similar to what's called like a Project Life layout. This paper, this grid, is not from Becky Higgins. This is actually from We Are Memory Keepers, as is this album. They come in these sleeves like this, and this is what I had bought back in 2010. So I had kind of started with this concept back in 2010, and I just never finished it. So that's why I want to wrap up this trip from 2010, get a few in there from 2011, and wrap up this year of 2012, and start fresh with a new album in 2013. So these are some of the photo sleeve packages that come with We Are Memory Keepers. This one's a nice combo. You can see it has one sheet of all these different types of pages. So I stuck that in here, and there's all different things from a plain 12 by 12 layout to all different types of configurations, and that really shows the grid set up really well. I just ordered the Becky Higgins to start 2013 because hers is more consistent in that most of them are like 4x6 and 4x3. And so it's very cut and dry and easy. You know the two sizes and you can just kind of go through it quickly. We'll see over time which one I end up liking better, but I'm going to finish this year with my We Are Memory Keepers since I have so many of them still in here. So that's how it started, and I like most of their things, most of their pages. This one has been the most challenging, though, because I do like the 4x6s, of course, but it had this small sliver, and it happened to work out perfect for the Chrysler Building, but when I moved on to work on the next page, which is all about bubbles, it's a little bit of a challenge. So I think I'm going to make that a title and say bubbles all the way down. And I do have to staple it because this pocket is so tiny, everything tends to slide out of it. So this one particular page protector I find challenging, but all the others I really like. So these, I need to do my journaling spots in there. Same with this one. I just have one spot left that I need to do a journaling spot for over there. This was fireworks. Do you know in Connecticut, I'm in Texas. In Texas, you can only get fireworks like 3 days around July 4th and 3 days around January 1st. In Connecticut, they sell them year-round. So we were there in June and doing fireworks, and they did them like two or three times that week. So they were really excited. They got to do all the fireworks they wanted to. There's some other things and events we did with my parents that I haven't been able to scrapbook there yet. So some of my earliest videos on YouTube were using this paper pack. This was from Close to My Heart. And so this was really cute. But again, I haven't finished the journaling, so I'm going to do that. And this is a pond my mom took us to. And then it kind of stops. And then you probably saw this layout that I did on YouTube. And pretty much all the other layouts in this book are the ones you've seen here on YouTube. So I'm going to finish this book one way or another. And let me show you some of the, well, you can't really see the page protectors really well. So these are the page protectors, and you can see they're all different shapes, all different sizes, and I have tons of them in here. So I am going to wrap up 2012 in here and see how that goes. And then hopefully I get a nice fresh start with Becky Higgins' version. And they have one coming out in December called Olive that I really love. So I'm seriously thinking about buying that. But for the moment, to finish this project, I've been downloading printables off of Pinterest and other people's blogs. And I'll link all those and show those little by little as I do these pages. So that's the story of why I've decided finally to do Project Life. The phrase on this page was really beautiful. This is actually Webster's Pages, and it's their Fresh Market series, and it opens up by saying, "Another fresh new year is here, another year to live." So let's see. So banish worry, doubt, and fear. So I thought that was very appropriate, and for my girls to be able to see the good times that we did have and good times we will continue to have. Even though we have this extra challenge in our lives, we're going to continue to have plenty of good times. Thanks for watching.